So, hello everyone. For those of you who haven't met me yet, my name is Claire Stoffel and I am working at the BIOP. So this is the Bioimaging and Optics Core Facility of the École Polytechnique Fédérale in Lausanne, Switzerland. So at the BIOP, since we are a microscopy core facility, we're used to offer support on different microscope system for sure, and also to help users with their image processing and analysis. But more recently, to facilitate the management of the microscopy images, we have set up and deployed an OMERO installation for the users from our institution. So this is quite new because we run a pilot phase of kind of 3.5 months. And then we started the production in the beginning of last month. So this is a new installation, a new service for our institution. And now that this OMERO service is in place, we are struggling a bit to motivate users to store their images in OMERO. So we decided to face this problem by trying to develop connectors between OMERO and tools that are already in use at our facility. So basically, the idea behind developing the connector that I am presenting you today was to create an OMERO image loader, which would be compatible with Fiji's big plugins, which are fully integrated with the Fiji BigDataViewer. So by the big plugins, what I meant is plugins that includes Big Stitcher, the alignment tool for multi-tile and multi-angle image data sets that are acquired, for example, by light jet, wide field, or confocal microscopes. It also includes Big Warp, the landmark-based deformable image alignment tool, and also lab kits and big volume viewer, etc. So this connector that I'm presenting you today, it is a very early stage project implementing an image J command for displaying OMERO images in Big Data Viewer. So like I just said, it is still very experimental, but I hope it will already show you what we are aiming to do and how things should work in the end. So if I had to sum up, our connector can stream raw data from OMERO in Big Data Viewer. And we are doing this using OMERO raw pixel store from the OMERO API. So it can handle 5D multi-resolution images, and it provides lazy loading of these images thanks to the cell loaders from Big Data Viewer. So enough presentation, let me start the live demo. So I will have to open my other computer, sorry. And yeah, so this is the Maven project. It's written in Java, and I will just start the commands in Fiji. Let's let it open. So I have my instance of Fiji here, and the little graphical interface from Fiji is asking me my OMERO host, as well as for sure the okay, this is said Gaspar because this is how we name the username and password at our institution, but then everyone can from the institution can connect with its own uni credentials. Then I have to enter the ID of my OMERO image. I will show you an example with a brain fluorescent image. This is a VSI file from a slide scanner that I have in my OMERO. So I have two options. I can check the auto contrast and choose to display the image in Big Data Viewer. And let's see what is going on. So this is opening the source window from the Big Data Viewer, as well as the image in Big Data Viewer. And you can see that if I zoom in the image, then it will load the different multi-resolution and yeah, it will load the resolution according to the zooming factor of the user. And also, yeah, this is managed by Big Data Viewer. I have a queue system, and then so the viewing window of the users is the highest priority in the queue for displaying and loading the resolution. So yeah, this is a quick example. Then I can show you another one with a 3D image. So now that I have my image tray here, I can access the plugin in directly from here. This is the Open OMERO multi-resolution image in BDV command. So again, I will put my password, and I will change the ID to show you another file. So this one is a TIFF file also in my OMERO. And here, this is a three-dimensional image. So what I can show you, if I scroll the mouse, I will load different Z position. And I can also show you if I press Shift X, then we can see the loading in the YZ plane. Where we can, okay, and it's soon to be finished. So let's go back to the XY view, and yeah, that's it for the 3D demo. But now I want to show you another thing with the first image. So if I open again the image, the brain fluorescent image. So let's open it. And I can show you that I can already use the big warp thanks to our connector. So let's open first an image from the Atlas. So this is the brain slice that I have also in my OMERO instance here. So I will also open it in Big Data Viewer, and I will put it on the brain slice. So let's open the slice from the Atlas. I have it on my OMERO, so I can open it from here using the plugin. And okay, this is my brain slice from the Atlas that is showing on top of my fluorescent image. And since I have my two images opened as BDV sources, I can now launch a big warp. Let's run it. And I will select the three channels from my OMERO image, so the brain fluorescent image, as moving sources, and I will select the two channel corresponding to the Atlas slice as fixed source. I can now minimize this window here and maximize a bit the two others. Oops. Sorry, let's do that here. And now I have my two images here, and I will have to add different landmarks to map my fluorescent image on the Atlas. So let me begin by putting just four points, one in each quarter of the brain. So let's put four points here. And now I can go into my moving image here and press F to display the two on top of each other. I will minimize this one. And if I press T, then it will do the transformation using my landmarks. And now with the lazy loading and etc., I can also fine tune my mapping, and I will be able to view my brain as a highest resolution, and then I will be able to fine tune a bit the mapping here. Oops. This is not the best. Maybe I should do this in the fixed image. This would be better. Sorry, this is live. Let's do that here. And yeah, it's because I added another point. Okay, so let's move again, zoom in. And from here, I will be able to adjust the mapping here, etc. So that's basically it for the demo. I'm not a big warp expert, as you can see, but at least we managed to make this compatible with the big warp plugin from Fiji. So let's go back to my presentation. Just a few more words on the next step. So the next step for this project will be, we are thinking of how to save the big warp transformation, maybe as a JSON file, and we would like to make it easy to link the transformation to the original image in OMERO, for example, as an attachment. And also, we would like to make this connector work with Big Stitcher. And yeah, this is the, I would say, the next very next step of this work. We just need to retrieve the slide position, and then we should be able to make this work with Big Stitcher. And also another project that we have in mind here would be to use the same method, so the raw pixels store from the OMERO API, to make the OMERO QPath connector work on raw pixel data. So that's it for today's demo. Now, if you have questions, feel free to ask. I also put here the link to the GitHub repo. Feel free to have a look into it and to ask me questions if this is not very clear. So because this is an ongoing project, then there may be a lack of comments and etc. So feel free to ask me if you want to make it work on your OMERO installation.
Hi, Claire.
Hello.
I've got a question. I kind of missed the first part of it. Whether you actually your files in within OMERO, is it OME TIFF or is it H5, the original big data format?
It's the original file formats, and that's okay. Basically the point of this connector.
Yes,
we wanted to access the raw data directly. So the first one that I showed you, it was a VSI file from a slide scanner that I have in OMERO, and I access directly the raw pixel data using the raw pixel stores from the.
At the moment the file is not the output from the big stitcher yet, or is the output from the big stitcher?
Can you repeat?
Is your file a how do you say it? The output of the big stitcher?
The big warp for the moment, because okay.
So so that file get imported into OMERO. Am I correct on that?
No, for now, the transformed image is not saved back to OMERO. So yeah, this is the thing we are thinking about. I mean, how to save this transformed, the transformation from BigWarp and link it to the original image. So yeah, for sure, this is the next step, because if we stop our work now, this is pointless.
Okay. I mean,
yeah, accessing the images is quite a big start.
Yes,
and playing with them in Big Data Viewer as well. But yeah, for sure, we will try to manage a way to save the transformation back to OMERO.
All right. And sorry, just one last question. So from the OMERO, OMERO Web or OMERO Insight, do you have does OMERO render the current images or not?
That's more OMERO question, but the OMERO Web, you have what you can see is a rendered image.
See the rendered image. Okay, so all right.
Yeah, that's why we are not using the web API to access the images. Otherwise, it would be RGB images, but we are using a...
Using the direct pixel reader. Yeah. Okay. Got you. Okay. Thanks.
Hi, hi, Greg. So you, at the moment, QPath, am I correct that QPath purely interacts with OMERO via its web API?
Exactly, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right. So, and the limitation on getting the raw pixel data is because the web only offers rendered images currently, right?
So I
would like, if possible, to try and address that question, because that's kind of in the pipeline, and it's something that it would be nice to try and address that issue and allow it to, so for example, by providing the ZAR, OME ZAR API from the web. So part of my preference for that is because, well, it's something that would be nice to do anyway, but also then you don't have any Java, you don't need the correct Java code, the correct version of the Java client library in QPath in order to be able to correct the correct version of OMERO. So when you update your OMERO server, you don't have to update a new jar in QPath. You know, so the web API is less brittle to version changes.
Okay, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So if you're trying to think about different options, that's my preference for trying to fix that issue. I don't know if you started working on that yet, but
yeah, I'm really not familiar with the OMERO microsystem, but I know that this should be the future. I mean, how we should see the future, and I think Pete has that in mind too. That the future of OMERO QPath should be with OMERO as well. We are just thinking of maybe a solution that could happen sooner and could help our users, yeah, at least at our institutions, because they are a lot relying on QPath, and we would like to use that as well as a catchy thing to put images to OMERO as well. But yeah, we are completely aware that the future will be this OMERO thing. And if we could make this compatible with the current QPath connector, then
that'd be
great. The best for sure.
Yeah. just one other question, I guess, is so I don't really know about the Java side of connecting Fiji to OMERO very well at all, but it strikes me that one thing that you could benefit from is some way of choosing your image instead of having to put the image ID in, you know, to be able to browse.
Yeah. For sure.
At least in our, in the OMERO ImageJ connector, you can connect, you basically load up Insight, and then when you browse to your image and you double click to open your image, it opens it in Fiji. I don't know if something similar is possible to do with BigDataViewer as well.
Yeah, it should be.
Or some code that we can somehow reuse some existing code to provide a project data set when you choose it without having to write it yourself. I don't know, but that'd be,
that'd be exactly fun. Basically, we had the same discussion on the first session with this demo. And two different ideas came. Like one would be to provide the URL of the image so that from the URL, we could retrieve the image ID and also the host name, etc. And the other could be to have a look into the, like, the other OMERO Fiji connector, the one by Curtis, that we have, I don't remember who told me that he had something like a tree view to access data from OMERO directly. So that could be integrated, for example, to enhance the experience for the users.
Okay, yep, sounds great. Cool, thanks.
Are there maybe other questions? Otherwise, we can close this breakout room, I think, and go back to others.